Five reasons why you should put a snake plant in your bedroom. Number one, according to NASA's Clean Air Study, some plants are better at producing oxygen, and snake plants are considered to be one of the highest oxygen-producing plants. Number two, most plants only produce oxygen during the day. Snake plants are one of the few plants that continues to produce oxygen at night, which helps with better sleep. Number three, snake plants remove harmful toxins like pollutants that can be found in cleaning supplies and regular household products, which means they're also great at combating allergies. Number four, they're super easy to take care of and can thrive in any kind of lighting scenario and don't require a lot of water. And number five, they're aesthetically pleasing.
People keep telling me you shouldn't have plants in your bedroom. They'll suffocate you because they produce CO2 at night. And while that is true, I kindly let them know that with all the men I ask to choke me, a plant is not going to be the one to suffocate me.
Okay, you know what, asshole? Pull the trigger. My life couldn't get any fucking worse.
This love is getting expensive. We know how to live, baby.
Love's gonna get you killed, but pride's gonna be the death.
I found the cutest self-watering mushroom. It's so strainy grainy. You just stick it into your plant's soil, fill it with water, and it will drink the water it needs.
Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He always been faking me out. He always been faking me out.
Not that thirsty.
Brand new whip, just hopped in. I got options.
Chug chug.
Like
slurp slurp.
Just joshing. I'm spending this holiday locked in. My body got rid of them toxins. Sports in the top.
Give me that water.
I in the end zone, put a bad bitch in the friend zone. This shit sound
okay,
like
now
just
get me out.
Told pool, he'll fool with the shit. Told her, don't let her
just
know.
A little drink.
Like a dime. Even fettuccine or Vincenzo's.
No thanks.
Got that free smoke on the west coast. Yeah, I'm talking about pre-roll.
One gulp is all I want.
She look like she go. She do. Hometown
just
hero. Feeling
a
myself.
Taste.
Can't murder my ego. She heard of my deep stroke. She said, babe, does it hurt?
I was hanging with you and then I realized.
Number one, all of us crazy plant people know that one windowsill is not enough, so hang shelves across your windows. Just go to your local hardware store and get whatever size wood you need, and I use these L brackets to attach it to the wall. And just so you know, Home Depot and Lowe's will cut the wood to the exact size you need. Hack number two, hang plants above your doorway because it looks really cool when they hang down. I also use L brackets to hang these shelves. But to hang your shelf above a doorway, you just need to flip it upside down. Mind blown yet? Hack number three, get some of these command hooks. They're really cool because the hook swivels so you can hang it on the ceiling. Then you can trail your long vining plants across the ceiling. It creates a really cool jungle vibe. You can also use additional hooks for any of your fooler plants. Follow along for more crazy plant lady stuff.
5 plants that are easy to take care of, that are not boring, and will not break the bank. Philodendron micans, fast growing, keep the soil moist, and just bright and direct sunlight. Monstera adansani, just need to keep the soil moist, does not need much light, and is fast growing. Calathea rattlesnake just needs humidity, keep the soil moist, and also does not require much light. Very pretty too. Ficus elastica ruby, this requires bright and direct light, needs some humidity, and just keep the soil moist. Philodendron birkin is a now much easier to find plant, bright and direct light, and keep the soil moist. You know I'm just a flight away, if you wanted you could take a private plane, a kilometros estamos conectando. Watermelon sugar high, 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 watermelon
things I wish I knew when I first got into houseplants. Misting doesn't really do anything, it's fun though. Most plants can handle and will appreciate small periods of direct light. Don't water on a strict schedule. Pay attention to signs from your plant. You don't need high humidity to grow plants well. My average humidity is around 50%.